Today is 2nd of February 2021. We are discussing the pandas. We have already given the pandas one lecture. This is lecture number 2. It's a kind of bit of repetitive. The pandas is a great thing to Python. See, Python itself is a core subject, is very, very weak compared to C, Java. When the Python comes with the NumPy, then Python is little bit powerful. It can do a lot of things. So you know all these things because pandas, Python doesn't have inbuilt array facility. It has inbuilt list, which is very different from C array. So, but whenever you import NumPy, is much more powerful than C array. You know the NumPy, the contiguous huge memory area you can claim for it. And not only that, you can also set whether the integer byte is 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit, 64. You can quantify, but it has to be contiguous. That's the great point of it. But there is a negative point of also in the NumPy. In NumPy, you can have a scalar, vector or matrix, everything you can do. But the problem is you cannot, all should be of same type. If anything is of different type, or if some point has no value, you cannot put to in NumPy. So, taking a real life example, say I have already mentioned the data science. The data science means at any point you are making a decision, like you are today you are attending this lecture. In fact, lot of data points is generated at what time you log in and what are your activities, what are mouse activities, whether you are doing some other activities. Everything is logged at some place or another. It might be the Google's place, or might be if you do Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram. So there, everybody is keeping data, and your data is being there. And from this data, they can generate how to put you ad and all these things. Then the data size has come. That is the one negative aspect of this, the marketing point of view. But you cannot deny that Google is running. Google is giving all the free service to you because of his marketing, and that is his strength. And there are, every company has its own strength. Amazon is also giving lots of services. It can give you books and all. It starts from books. Now, so your data points is generated. Whatever your activity right now, maybe with half an hour activity, lot of data points is generated. And this data will not be a numerical one. It data can be date format, time format. It data can be yes, no, very good format. It data can be categorical format. I'll come. What is categorical data? What is nominal data? And dumb data that may not have values. All these different types of data you have to take for your intelligence programming, and then you have to take decisions. Then you need not NumPy. NumPy is very cruel. NumPy cannot handle this kind of different types of data. NumPy is very good if you have a integer data, floating point data, that is pretty good. But whenever there is not a data, maybe data mixed with character, data mixed with date, then you need to clean the data. You have to put the data in some data frame, that is the pandas is giving. And in the data frame, you can put more or less any type of data. Only thing is, data should be of a rectangle type. Only the is a data column length should be equal, that's all. And in each column can be any damn thing. It can be a dictionary itself. It can be list. It can be a NumPy array. But all the column length, the data frame is nothing but a collection of columns. And instead of SQL table, instead of rows. So it's totally different. In Excel table, it is a consist of rows. Is a rectangular, but in pandas it is a same rectangular, but it is a columns, and columns have to be of equal length. That's all the restriction. There is no other restriction, and the columns may contain the list, contains a NumPy array, can in fact another pandas data frame can be there. So this all the things. So this is very ideal platform, the pandas. It takes the data from various Google source and Facebook source. For Twitter is another thing, the data is there. So from there you can make intelligence more, you can process the data. So pandas is like this. So any doubt, you can always raise question, and this is online class. Anything, any question please? Yeah, So this is pandas. So there are lots of funny things. I like the funny things about the pandas, like Chinese panda. I don't know relationship, but it is so, you know, cute and all these things. Let's see the next slide. Yeah, this is the categorical data. This is categorical data, like gender, like earlier male female, right now male female, LGBTQ, maybe third. I heard the USA, whenever you have to fight sex type, you have 12 types there, not male female. There may be 12 types in USA. I heard it in some talk shows. So these are all categorical data. Categorical data, that means you cannot say a male is greater than a female or female is greater than a male. It is just a, this is it, a boy or girl or male female or student teacher, it's like this, categorical data. And there is another thing is come, there's nominal data. Yeah, data can be like this. Data can be categorical, that I have told you, that is numerical data, like your number, your grade point and all this. And categorical data is also a nominal one. Nominal means there is no interrelationship between it. And ordinal means first, second, third, fourth, sixth, like this. So these various types of data has to be handled for any data science problem. Whenever you are taking data and all, you have to have all this data. Yeah, any question you can tell. So this is an example of categorical data. Nominal data like pen, pencil, eraser, cow, dog, any, there is no relation between pen and cow and like this. Ordinal data is excellent. Excellent must be greater than good. Good must be greater than bad. Or fantastic, okay, some kind of sentiment analysis program in machine learning, you have to, this ordinal data is very useful. So whether the that site is liked or not, that product is liked or not. So these are the different types of data. Yeah, I have said again, categorical, quantitative, quantitative then discrete, it is a countable and continuous, it is, there'll be floating point numbers and all this. So various ways you can look, you can leak data, like quantitative data, like height, weight, income, university, size and all. Categorical data, gender, religion, method of treatment, types of teaching, marital status. These are categorical data. If there is no such relationship among it, it is just it. So these are the various types of data you will be in, you'll get it. So like these types of data, I'm again repeating, nominal. Just you, this slide is very important. Types of data, categorical and nominal data, ordinal data and discrete data. And you remember there is various types of, not only real, floating point, date is also very, the time is also there. There can be there in any kind of data in this, so continuous data. So your, for processing this, NumPy is very naive. So there is a, pandas is there. The library that makes it powerful. So for all machine learning application, I have told again and again, Python is basically for machine learning. So if somebody wants to make a Android app application, nobody will choose Python because Python is the slowest there. It may be Java or recently two language, Kotlin and another language is there, both supported by Google. That is good for Android app. That is good. So if say Android app Java is good and all, but whenever it's a machine learning, so then the Python is there. Python and probably R is also close second. So there you have to know these kinds of tools. Yes. So next, go to the next slide. Yes, this is, I have told you, the data frame. So these are the columns, and these are the columns and these are rows and names. Here it has been found all other names itself. It may not be. Some name can be blank, yeah, not a number, or some name can be a floating point number. So there is no exception will be thrown by this Python or pandas. Yeah, so this is a concept of columns and rows. The data is not ordered by rows, but you can put your data in rows, but ultimately they will be in a columns. The column should be equal length. Okay, so they set this, yeah. Yeah, so this is fun. I have already covered in last class, so I'm not going into details. So this is a series, it is called a series. This columns is called series, and number of series is called the data frame. And this is the Python, the NumPy, then with the NumPy, the pandas should have built on NumPy and Python, core Python. Then I'll cover the next day. I already covered SciPy and I already covered Matplotlib. So I have a separate quiz for SciPy, that is all an MCQ on Google Formbase and Matplotlib. Then I have already done a little bit of TensorFlow and PyTorch. So we quickly finish up in another next 2 weeks with quizzes. So that's it. If you have any kind, then our target will be that you should develop a small project where all these tools are required, not the basic format of the Python. You should handle this kind of library to your small project work. Yeah, let's next. Yeah, this is I have a pandas data structure. This is a series, this is a series name I've already discussed, probably pandas built on NumPy arrays. That I have already in my pandas do. And these are the average series. Yeah. One great thing on the pandas is that, like NumPy also, you can put the date time. NumPy doesn't have the date time object. This is a date time object. It is there, but Python, it is in pandas, will use it. So let's see in the actual code itself. Then it will be much more clearer. Yeah. Hope so. I think it is. Screen is visible, please. Anyone? Yeah. Screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Yeah. The this code is, I think, let the size maybe a little bit bigger. Hope so. So this is a code I generally run in Colab. I've already explained what are the steps in Colab I prefer, like import OS I always do, so that you can see the commands and Python version. You can show this which Python version is running, like Python version 3.69 and ID of the process in the main program, because you're actually basically using a PC, remote PC there at Google, and there are some processes are running. So you have a feeling that what is the process's number. Every time you run, that would be different. And this is features like in Java thread. The same, if you run Java, the main thread is main thread. That is Python are the same. You know, remember that Python is developed earlier than Java in 1990. Java is developed 1996 by James Gosling. Tipu with not found. I have checked it, some standard code. So these are my basic framework. Today I want to show that I am creating a panda series. Yeah, panda series basically a column, and you see it has no, it is not a number itself. And y.np.nan, it can be tf.nan. Actually, what I want to see, this nan is not a number, and np means it's kind of a namespace, like names of a Rai Choudhury. Like I am Somnath Rai Choudhury, my father's name is B.N. Rai Choudhury. Rai Choudhury is my namespace. And my daughter is Vishwari Rai Choudhury. So NP is here, the namespace, and it may be a TensorFlow can be have tf.nan. So that nan is defined. If you say only nan, then Python is confused. Which nan? Maybe Matplotlib has another. If you say Matplotlib has a PLT, then plt.nan may be different. So that is the reason. This is the qualifier, yeah, namespace qualifier, and I always prefer this print type, as you can see what is the basic things is running. That's the thing. So this is, I have the last class also we have covered. The new thing today I wish to cover this one I wish to cover just here. See, I have a cover a periods. So that is a great thing. In a NumPy you cannot have. I intentionally take 13 so that it is not month. I don't want to show that is a days. And whenever you say, I have never covered it is a day. But if you print type of dates, it is automatically set frequency is D. So if I create it pd.e with periods m. Hopefully that would create months is a period. Am I correct? So that is a great thing. You can create a period in the Panda data frame. That is one thing, and you can show it. These are the periods. 13 periods have been created. And another one I want to show. This one. Please be with P. Yeah, this is a very simple one. This is, I am creating a data NP array. This is a basically tuple. This is, I am creating with a list, and then I NP column names, temperature and activity. Then I create my data frame. That is, whenever you say data frame, you call pd.dataframe. That is the great thing. And then you say data is this one is the data, and columns is my column names. What are the my columns names? And then you run this. So this is, I always prefer that, what is the print type? So it is this 0, 3 and all. And another great point, if you want to add a data, create a new column and name to adjust it, you want to add, I want to say another column name to data frame. I just say my data frame adjusted, a new data frame. Remember, this is a new data frame and my data frame activity plus 2. And if you say print, so if you see the activity and there's another column is added and it is just at plus 2. So that's it. That is summarize. I want to summarize the thing. The Pandas is a great thing and it's a basically a data staging tool. Because whenever you are making a data science application, you collect the data from various sources, maybe comma separated file, maybe your image file, maybe audio file. So all this file cannot be input into a same container. So what the thing is, these files has to be brought in and then have to be cleansing the data. So what is the cleansing? There may be some data is collected maybe in days. Some data is collected weekly, so you cannot make a sale forecast with various kinds of data. So days data would be put in a days format, and your months data at a months format. Then you have to granularize data. You have to put the data in a queue form, and for this kind of cleansing the data, and where the missing data is there, you can put this data. And also, you know, the data is are various types. Categorical data, that means boy and boy, girl, and like this, and nominal data like excellent, good, excellent. So all these various kinds of data and date time data, you have to put it, and then you can create some data science application. So now I'm open to questions. So you can ask any question, please.